The dental light. The dental light is a particularly controversial topic since it is not exactly an artifact of potential ancient technology, but the possible depiction of an artifact on the wall of one of the best preserved ancient temples in Egypt, the temple of the Egyptian goddess Hathor Adentera. The dental light is found on three stone reliefs and, at first glance, could be construed as a lamp with a cable at the end and a snake-shaped cord inside. A priest is holding the lamp at one end, and a few smaller figures are below it with one appearing to hold the lamp upwards. A Norwegian electrical engineer was the first to propose that the image depicted an electrical lamp. Peter Krasa and Rainer Habeck published a book based on the relief titled Lights of the Pharaohs, and Zeknun Garnburn, another electrical engineer, later constructed a working model of the dental lamp. Most Egyptologists, however, interpret the image much differently. The Hermopolitan myth of creation, the first thing to emerge from the primordial sea of Nun, which pre-existed creation, was a lotus flower. That flower gave birth to the sun god, Aten-Ra. There are many ancient depictions of the lotus in the shape of a lamp similar to the relief above, and in later depictions a snake in a bubble was used to represent Aten-Ra. The bubble or field around the snake may represent the emergence of the universe out of nothingness. Therefore, an obvious implication to the meaning of the dental lamp, according to Egyptologists, is a reference to the sun god emerging from the lotus flower. Scholars also point out there is no reference in historical texts of the use of light or electricity, which one would expect to find if it really were an electrical lamp, nor have any electrical items been uncovered in the thousands of archaeological sites throughout Egypt. Whatever the conclusion regarding the dental relief, it continues to draw crowds from around the world who are eager to catch a glimpse of the unusual carving. The Saqqara bird. The Saqqara bird is an artifact that was found in Egypt near the Saqqara pyramid in 1898, during the excavation of the Pahtiamun tomb. The artifact, which resembles a bird, has been the topic of many debates and many explanations. This interesting artifact is made of wood and estimated to be about 2,200 years old. Though its shape resembles a bird, it more closely resembles a modern airplane with the head of a bird. Furthermore, the hieroglyphs on the model airplane read the gift of Amun, and three papyrus found near the artifact mention the phrase "I want to fly." All these characteristics sparked Dr. Khalil Messiha, the physician who discovered the artifact in 1898, to speculate that the ancient Egyptians first made it as a model of an aircraft they either built or witnessed. He claimed that the Saqqara bird had aerodynamic qualities and that the only thing missing from the bird was the tail wing stabilizer with which, he speculated, it would have been capable of flying. To support his claims, Messiha built a balsa wood model and added the tail, surprised to see that the model indeed could fly. In 2006, Simon Sanderson, an aviation and aerodynamics expert, also constructed a replica of the Saqqara bird and tested its aerodynamic in a wind tunnel, but without the tail. The result was that it could produce four times its weight in lift. However, another attempt to test the flying capabilities of the Saqqara bird performed in 2002 by glider designer Martin Gregory produced different results. He created a balsa wood model and his conclusions were that without a tail wing stabilizer it was unable to fly, and even with the tail the performance was disappointing, suggesting that it was probably meant to be a toy. Mainstream archaeologists support that the artifact is nothing but an actual bird that, by coincidence, resembles a glider. And although its function is unknown, most of them agree that it was a part of a masthead that was used on sacred boats. We know that the Egyptians built an advanced civilization and were experts in architecture, engineering and art. Is it possible that this was a model constructed in an effort to create a flying machine? The papyrus found next to the object, as well as the special characteristics of the Saqqara bird, would probably reject the naive opinion that it was designed to be a mere toy. Taking into account that the bird depicted cannot be found anywhere in nature, it is possible to imagine that the ancient Egyptians could have seen something in the air, perhaps some kind of flying machine that they couldn't comprehend, thus transferring the bird face to the object. Please subscribe now for more videos.